Fisherman James Sally narrowly survived a hippo attack. He narrates his ordeal. After I was done fishing that day, I turned the boat towards the landing area, but little did I know that the hippo had camped on the shore. I vividly remember the ugly scenario, me trying to run away, to escape, to save my own life. Residents are concerned that attacks by hippos have destabilized families. Gardens are continuously destroyed. Parents are worried about the safety of their school-going children. Richard Setuba, the speaker of Bugoye sub-county, says the hippos have affected fishing and also fishermen are constantly in fear.
We lost our residents, one of the residents. We lost him. He was killed by a hippo. So we don't want to lose another resident in our community.
He has reiterated Uganda Wildlife Authority's call to protect the animals. However, he has also asked the authority to handle the situation immediately.
We call upon the UWA and the government of Uganda to come on board and help the residents of this community so that they can take these hippos or they can help.
1, 2, 3 animals should be killed because I know that UWA will not come here and take them away. But they are keeping them here and the other sectors of our economy are getting worse.
The hippos are believed to have migrated from Bukakata Bay, where they killed 2 fishermen and injured 3 others at the beginning of this year.
No more. And this is affecting the economy of the country because this is one sector that has been moving. Now, another sector that has been affected is the fisheries sector, where the country is getting a lot of money. But because of just these 1, 2, 3 animals, the sector is not moving. And the country is bound to lose a lot of taxes from these people.
Residents say the hippos are sometimes seen around the lake, mainly in areas where the shoreline is covered with papyrus that harbor lives of dangerous aquatic animals. Report by Samuel Nkuba for the news.